The second top question was quite interesting, and it was liked quite a lot. I wonder if there would be advantages to increasing the word size more and more on a CPU core, and then using portions of the very long word size for different purposes rather than using multiple cores. So what that's saying is you would, rather than having two cores, one doing one thing and one doing the other, running their own instructions, you'd have an extra long instruction which encoded lots of things at once. Now, this is actually called, I don't know if the person who asked this was aware, but this is actually called VLIW, very long instruction word. And I did a bit of Googling and found this presentation on SlideShare, submitted by the people down there, which contrasts them. And so this is basically two very different approaches to doing parallelism. So superscalar is basically, we didn't mention the term, but it's the ability of actually a single core to do more than one thing at once. And I think I mentioned this when I was trying to calculate the peak performance of Archer. Actually, modern CPU cores can cope with multiple instructions at once. So you can ask a CPU core to do an integer instruction, a floating point multiply, floating point addition, and you just throw those three instructions at it at the same time. And if it's able to, it will, although they come in individually, it will execute them at the same time. So that's done. That's called superscalar. And the point here is this is done dynamically at runtime by the hardware. You just throw all these instructions at it, and the hardware works out at runtime if it can do them at the same time. So you need to do some dependency checking. You need to check if you've got the resources and the ability to do these things, they don't clash with each other. But and you need to do various other techniques. But this is the modern technique which is used, and it seems to work very well. What the person who asked that question was suggesting was VLIW, very long instruction word. And what you do there is at compile time, the compiler has to look at your code and say, ah, I see that there's an integer instruction there and a floating point instruction. They could be done at the same time, and it would pack them together into a single instruction. And it's the compiler which does this data dependency. The compiler works out when it can do it. And I mean, it just turns, this was quite popular, maybe, I'm sort of guessing here, I'm not a hardware expert, 10 years ago there was a chip produced by Intel called the Itanium, which had that architecture. But the problem is it puts a lot of stress on the compiler. It means the compiler has to do a lot of analysis, and compilers have to be very conservative. If a compiler is ever unsure about what's getting the wrong result, it will take the conservative approach and do things safely. And it just turned out that it was very hard for the compiler to do that. Also, the compiler has to be quite specific to the architecture. You have to optimize the compiler for particular architectures, and that's a lot of work. So I said I'm not an expert here, but I have Googled around a bit, and although they're both reasonable approaches, it's turned out that in the wash, with very, very fast modern processors, where we have a lot of transistors because of Moore's law, we can put a lot of logic and a lot of technology, a lot of decision making on a modern CPU core. What turns out to be most efficient is the thing which sounds a bit more ugly, but is superscalar. So that is, the compiler doesn't really do much of an analysis. The compiler just generates all the instructions in a very fast stream. And superscalar means that at runtime, the CPU core can take these and operate them in parallel, do these instructions in parallel if it thinks it can. And it's turned out the superscalar is more efficient, more advantageous than VLIW. So it was a very interesting observation 10 years ago, and maybe the jury was out as to which was best, but it turns out that superscalar has won over VLIW.